like anything else, experience new, you know, every year, every game. You know, I remember years gone by, I think Debbie Timon, who's in our marketing department, obviously has been running that for a long time. She had a slogan back in the 80s, at any moment, a great moment. So, you know, so I would pass along with experience you get at any moment, a new, you know, experience, a new moment, a new stimuli where you're dealing with something you've never had to deal with before. And obviously here in the pressure cooker in New York, and being the manager of the Yankees now four straight years with various experiences, whether it's on, you know, offense, pitching, defense, you know, personal off the field, you know, issues with players or contract walk years, all the above. I think all those things have served Aaron well. He's growing already, and already has grown and will continue to grow. That's one of the reasons we're attracted to him, is because, you know, it's not like it's a finished product, you know, and that's what you don't want. You don't want to be in a position where this is what you get and that's all you're getting, and the ceiling is the floor, essentially. In his case, you know, I think ultimately he's grown into being one of the better managers in the game. You know, I was dealing with a few of the general managers that I respect in this industry as our season was going on, and they were like, hey, I read all this stuff about, you know, Boone. There's no way that's the case, is it? And it was good to hear from afar how other people perceive him, because I know I'm on the front line and I see what I see play out, and it's got nothing but great respect for how he goes about his business and how he handles it. So ultimately, you know, what we can do only as a front office is set a buffet table of array of choices and players at his disposal. And then he's charged with his coaching staff to determine lineups. He's charged with his coaching staff how he's going to manage the starting pitching staff, when to pull him in a game, obviously when to utilize a reliever, and factor in, obviously, the health protective side of things, and stay engaged with our medical staff about who might be available on any given day and who's not. And ultimately, the default for him has been, as you've seen, is he's a protector of the players. You know, he understands that, you know, what it's like to play this game and try to post every day, and some things, you know, are more available for public scrutiny than others. And, you know, he's going to be very protective of his personnel and of the process, you know, as he sees fit, because that's his default. So as I say all those things, I'm saying all his strengths, he's just a continually growing, evolving, you know, I think, person in that position. And I think he's already very good at it, really good at it. And that's why we've reinvested in it, because we believe in him. But I don't have any specific category. You've got to be better here, or, you know, I really don't. I think it's the managing position in Major League Baseball is very difficult. You got 162 games, obviously, of twists and turns in every category. And then you throw in a streaky situation like we dealt with this year. And then having to go, you know, pre and post game with the media, stay engaged with your players, keep them, try to find ways to motivate them, keep them healthy. And at the end result, it's a very challenging role for anybody. And it's even more challenging if you're in a big market. And I think he's demonstrated that he knows how to do it. He knows how to navigate it, and he's not afraid of it either. And he's not afraid to take the slings and arrows and stand up. And, you know, obviously the easy thing would be to, you know, say, I want out. I don't want any part of this. Instead, he's running to the problem to be a part of the solution. And I respect him a great deal for that.